Good morning, morning, everyone. Happy Easter. It's so delightful to see all of you here at Emmanuel Lutheran Church. I'm Jonathan Reading Shear, your music director. A huge welcome to all of you who may be visiting with us here. We're delighted you're here with us to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Couple of quick announcements. Should you have any questions, just grab any usher at the back. Restrooms are both downstairs and that way, should you need them. Couple of other quick announcements. Hey, here's your chance to get free COVID tests. Who would have thought that's what you come to East Church on Easter for? But we have literally, I counted 2,000, something like that. So help yourself. They're right there at the back. Take them away. Put them to good use. One thing we could definitely use help with today, which is we have quite a few shut-ins in our congregation, and one of the things that the Altar Guild helps coordinate on Easter is to take some of the beautiful plants that are up here at the front to our shut-ins. So basically, if you have time after service, you grab a plant from up here, you grab a card downstairs that has someone's address on it, and if you have time, you could deliver that plant to them. It means so much to people to be remembered at this time. Speaking of the Altar Guild, a huge thank you to all the people who have decorated our sanctuary today. It's looking great. I want to say a personal thank you to all the musicians who are here singing today. They've put a ton of work in. I'm so grateful to all of them. A couple of other quick announcements. First, Maureen, what have you got?
So I have. Happy Easter, everyone. It's so great to see everybody here. Happy Easter, Christopher. We have a really great challenge this morning. We've run out of bulletins. So the ushers have asked me to request that you share among families, and also those of you who are receiving your emails electronically, if you don't usually like to ask you to take your phones out in church, but if you want to view it by your phone, you can do that as well. So thank you for that. Please come back next week when we will welcome our new pastor. Next week, he will be coming to preach for us and lead the service, and we'd love to fill the pews again and have you meet the pastor. The call committee is very, very excited for Pastor Mark Olson to start on May 1st, but he will be here with us next week. Final announcement. Mike and I were talking in reference to mutual ministry, and we really thought it would be important to start highlighting our ministries, and what a better way to start on Easter, and what a better week to start on the week that we got our very new affirming RIC banners outside in the front. If you are exiting the church today through the front, or if you're not, go around to the front and check them out. They are beautiful. Speaking of banners, the ministry minute I would like to highlight is for Rayanne. Rayanne, who's sitting like two-thirds of the way across this way, straight ahead from me, has created, I don't know if you know, all of the banners, the freestanding banners that hang outside the church. She made 80 of them, I understand, with her own two beautiful hands, and has donated them to the church. So that's our ministry minute. If you didn't know, now you do. Happy Easter, everyone.
Good morning, happy Easter. I'm here to announce for the food the food pantry committee, I'm sorry. So information about the food pantry is that this past month we served 400 households. The items of the month are conditioner and shampoo, but we always need staples such as pasta and rice. We have 7 new volunteers from the community, but we are always in need of more volunteers, so let us know if you're able to volunteer at the food pantry. Thank you for any monetary donations that you can give as well. Children are on spring break this week, so during the distribution at the food pantry, we'll be giving more than usual to alleviate hunger for those families. The food pantry committee will be meeting every first Sunday of the month at 9:15 in the conference room if you are interested. Thank you.
Awesome. Sorry. Please stand as you're able for the Easter acclamation and our opening hymn.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Hymn number 365.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God, you gave your only Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption. By his glorious resurrection, you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin and rise each day to new life, that we may live forever in the joy of the resurrection through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. Our first reading this morning is from the book of Acts. Peter began to speak to the people. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ, Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us, who were chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. Word of God, word of life. Our second reading is taken from the third chapter of Colossians. If you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth, for you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Word of God, word of life.
In St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb, and suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead. And indeed, he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You You may be seated. The text for today's sermon is that gospel from St. Matthew. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Today, we can proclaim these words with great joy as we hear again of the greatest miracle and the greatest mystery of all times. We believe these words, knowing that in the depth of our souls, they are true. But with those words which we proclaim today, Christ is risen. With those words so easily roll off our lips if we went to the tomb on the first Easter morn. What would we say if we were given the task to proclaim this good news to a group of fearful and despairing disciples who had run away from their Lord in his hour of greatest need? And how would they respond when we delivered the good news, Alleluia, Christ is risen. And amen. Delivering this news of great joy, along with the imperative that the disciples go to Galilee, is exactly what the women are told to do on that very first Easter. They are given a great gift as they see the stone being rolled away. They are given a great message to deliver to the by an angel. And messages delivered by angels are not everyday events. They weren't back then, and they certainly aren't today. This in and of itself is a miraculous occurrence. And yet the greatest miracle occurs as the women hear the words, peer into the tomb, and find it empty. For in the word, they believe. In the darkness and emptiness, they believe. They believe Christ is risen. Sure, the lack of Jesus' appearance at the tomb must have been disappointing. For don't we expect more on Easter? Don't we want to see Jesus and not just an angel? Don't we want to see Jesus at the tomb robed in splendor, his face shining like the sun and his garments white as light? Wouldn't that be what we would need to believe the unmistakable truth that Christ is risen? And yet the women believe the words of an angel. The women believe through the emptiness of a tomb that Jesus has fulfilled his prophecy. And so they run to deliver the message. Even though at this point they have not seen Jesus, they don't linger or sulk and weigh and in sadness. They go quickly. They do not hide themselves in fear. They glow with hope, for they are no longer distant followers or simple women who can easily be ignored. In faith and obedience to the will of God, they are witnesses and evangelists. They are the ones appointed to share the good news. As they go on their way, suddenly and unexpectedly, the women are given another gift, as they are surprised as Jesus greets them. Jesus doesn't appear to intimidate the women, for he doesn't come to terrify, but to comfort and console. And the women, filled with awe, fall on their knees and grab hold of Jesus' feet as he reinforces the message that they are to deliver. If by chance they have had doubts in the words of the angel and in the barrenness of the tomb, the women doubt no longer. They have seen. They have seen with their own eyes. They have heard. They have heard with their own ears. They have touched with their own hands. And they have worshiped. They know beyond a shadow of a doubt. Christ is risen! Christ is risen. Surprisingly, this Easter greeting is not the message that the women are instructed to deliver, even though I have no doubt that those words would have rolled off their lips at some point. The women who are in the know are to tell the disciples who are still in the dark, reeling from the events of Good Friday, to go to Galilee, for there they will see Jesus. But how do you share that kind of news? That kind of incredible news, let alone convince 11 men who are hiding in fear of the Jews to leave the safety of their haven and go to Galilee. How do you stop your heart from beating out of your chest and calm down enough to share the fact that Jesus, the one you saw crucified and laid in the tomb, is alive? His body is not in the burial cave. He's not among the dead, but walking among the living. For Christ is rise. Christ is risen indeed. You know that to be true. But how do you convince people of what you saw and heard and touched is real and not just some hoax? You know what the women faced. I'm sure you've gotten the same kind of reaction from avowed non-believers. They see the resurrection as nothing more than a fairy tale, a story made up by people to control lives. To them, death is the final word. Not even those who believe in reincarnation accept the notion of a soul returning to a dead body. And yet the cave is empty. An angel speaks to the women in the same way that an angel spoke to Mary and Elizabeth before them, giving them good news. Only this news is more incredible than an unexpected birth. For the one who died is dead no more. Jesus lives. Death no longer has the final word. The final word belongs to God, and that word is a word of life. But what do you believe? Do you believe as the women? Do you believe Christ is risen? Christ is risen! And that God has broken through the barriers of a sorrow-laden world. Do you believe that God raised Jesus from the dead, and in his rising, God will raise you and me and all believers? Are you able to see the unexpected new things that God is doing among us and the unexpected things that God will do? And can you rejoice with me as I proclaim, Alleluia! Christ is risen! My friends, Easter is the greatest gift of all. It is a gift of life. And believing that Jesus rose from the dead is the greatest miracle of all, for it defies logic. May we believe the witness of women, and may we who are in the know tell those who do not know, Christ is risen. And that through faith in the risen Lord, we, like the women, are witnesses and evangelists. Let us be bold and share the good news, for indeed, alleluia, Christ is risen. And amen. And may the peace of God, which surpasses all human understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Let us join together in professing our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. You call your church to witness to your salvation. We give thanks for all theologians, preachers, and teachers who proclaim your gospel. Equip all the baptized. Equip all the baptized to share the joy of the resurrection in all we say and do.
Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. You bring abundant life throughout creation. The green blade rises, and all creation greets the resurrection dawn. Preserve vineyards and orchards and those who tend to them. Feed us with the fruits of creation.
Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. You show your steadfast love without regard to borders, barriers, or human-made divisions. Infuse justice in every nation of the world, that all experience the peace that only you can give.
Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. You anointed your Son with the Holy Spirit and with power. Encourage us by his example in our ministries of caring, healing, and outreach. We pray for all who are sick or hospitalized, especially Carol, Karen, Chris, Melissa, Anne Louise, Lee, the Jennings Marzette family, McKenna, Brooklyn, Irving, Elaine, Monique, Rayanne, Sierra, Harris, Orlando, Letitia, Holly, Vito, Bertel, Teresa, Kimeline, Shadizia, Rochelle, Mal, Betsy Ann, and all those we name now, either aloud or in the silence of our hearts, and for all healthcare workers who care for them.
Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. You have put gladness in our hearts. Inspire musicians and dancers to rejoice with songs of victory. Bless the music ministries of this congregation and all who foster this assembly's song.
Risen Lord, in your mercy,
As you have raised Jesus from the dead, you show us your resurrection promise. With your holy ones who have sung your praise, free us from fear and empower us to go and tell the good news.
Risen Lord, in your mercy, rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us pray. Generous God, in this meal you offer your very self, we give thanks for these gifts of the earth. In the breaking of this bread, reveal to us the risen one. In the pouring of this wine, pour out in us service to the world. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. We give you thanks, Father, through Jesus Christ, your beloved Son, whom you sent in this end of the ages to save and redeem us and to proclaim to us your will. He is your word inseparable from you, through whom you created all things and in whom you take delight. He is your word sent from heaven to a virgin's womb. He there took on our nature and our lot and was shown forth as your Son, born of the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin Mary. He, our Lord Jesus, fulfilled all your will and won for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands in suffering in order to free from suffering those who trust you. He is the one who handed over to a death he freely accepted in order to destroy death, to break the bonds of the evil one, to crush hell underfoot, to give light to the righteous, to establish his covenant, and to show forth the resurrection, taking bread and giving thanks to you. He said, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering then his death and resurrection, we take this bread and cup, giving you thanks that you have made us worthy to stand before you and to serve you as your priestly people. Send your spirit upon these gifts of your church. Gather into one all who share this bread and wine. Fill us with your Holy Spirit to establish our faith in truth, that we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through whom all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Come and know Christ, broken and poured out for you.
Elevator, they're probably not going to want to take her down the stairs. They can probably do it downstairs already. So then I'll get them. Thank you.
Please stand. Before the final communion blessing, let us pray for Mark. Marge. Almighty and gracious Lord, you know our every need. Please be with Marge during this time. Heal her and bring her back to us. Dear Lord, this has indeed been a strange Easter celebration, but one in which we can say we can rejoice because we know in all times and in all places you are with us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Everybody know, Marge is okay. She was laughing and joking with the firemen before going out, and she wanted the services to continue. So all of you have a blessed Easter.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed, hallelujah.